Notion added a brand new layout possibility for database pages with tabs. Database tabs could change the way many of us design and use Notion databases, and I'm excited to share my thoughts about it after trying it out. In this video, I'll be going over how to use database tabs and the pros and cons of it. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. Let's first go over how to add database tabs to your Notion databases. And for this purpose, I created a sample personal workspace that includes three databases, one which is a database of notebooks, another which are a database of notes that connect to your notebooks through a relation property, and then an event calendar that's an entirely separate database that just has basic events that you might want to track. And if you're not familiar with databases or you're a beginner with Notion, I highly recommend checking out some beginner tutorials first before diving into this one. But basically, with the database tabs, what you can do is showcase, for example, your notes inside of your notebooks in a really easy way. So if I open up my travel notebook here, I can go to Customize Layout. And then if you click Page Settings, you'll now see two options for the structure, Simple and Tabbed. If you choose the Tabbed option, you'll see that there's now this content, which is basically everything that's in the page as a page view. And you can now click this plus sign to add tabs. And when you click the plus sign, it's actually even going to tell you that you have a relation to notes here. So you can just click this one. And then it's already filtered by this page. So every single notebook entry is already going to be filtered out. So you only see notes for that notebook. For example, we have this one now. If you click this plus sign, you can also link existing databases from anywhere in your workspace. I can just showcase my event calendar here, add view. For this, I can change the layout to calendar so that it actually shows the events. And then I can just click apply to all pages. So now what's really cool is that even if I open my reading notebook, it's going to show my event calendar. It's going to show specific notes relating to my reading notebook. And every new notebook, for example, if this one is a personal notebook, then if I add a new entry here, new note about my day, and if I click out, it's already shown here, personal notebook. I can see all my notes filtered out. My event calendar is still here and my content looks the same. In the past, to achieve the same thing, you had to go through database templates. But the issue with database templates is that it only updates future entries and you have to actually go through manually and update them yourself for past entries. With this one, if you go to Customize Layout and now you decide to, for example, add a new sort for created time, apply to all pages, it automatically gets applied to every single notebook entry. So you can see here that it already has that sort here. So this is why database tabs can be a really useful way to add other databases references inside. Now let's go over the pros of using database tabs. So the main use case of database tabs is that it basically replaces the need to use database templates. So just to show you what it was like in the past before having this option, the only real way to do this would be to create a database template, for example, called New Notebook, where I add a linked view database and I link to my notes. I click view all, then I can filter it out by the relation and then make sure that it's related to all of the new notebook database template, save for everyone. If I click out and I click travel notebook and I load that database template, I can see all my notes relating to travel notebook. Same for if I load up this one for reading notes, it's gonna load the reading notebook notes. It basically replaces the need to have this with this tab. So as you can see, it's basically the same thing here. So you might wonder what would be the pros to using the tabs as opposed to having this kind of linked system here. The pros for this is the fact that right now, if you have a database template, you can't just apply it to every single notebook. You would have to go in manually and change it. For example, the personal notebook, I would have to click this and add it in. Any new ones, I could click here, set it as a default so that every time I create a new notebook, it's going to already load it in for me. The only issue is that let's say that I change my mind about this new notebook template and the way that the notes are displayed. Maybe I want my created time on the very left-hand side. Then if I click out and I click my travel notebook again, you'll notice that the created time is exactly where it was before. So if I want to replace this, I have to manually delete this and then load the new notebook again, at which point the created time appears on the left. It is really tedious to update your entire database with a database template. However, with the database tabs, if I go to my note, I click customize layout, then all I have to do is move this over here, apply to all pages. Every single one I open now is going to have that created time on the left-hand side, so I don't have to go in and manually change this. So this is one of the biggest pros to using the database tabs as opposed to having it inside of your page like this. The other pro to using database tabs is that for some people, it might be more intuitive to create this kind of tab than going to your database template, adding a linked view, and filtering it out like I showed earlier. So instead of that, it's pretty simple to go to customize layout and click the plus sign. It shows you exactly what relation you can add here. And if you want to link an existing database, let's say my event calendar, it even gives me the option to create a new relation out of this. Might be easier for some people to sort of understand the way that these kind of relational databases work. A few other pros could just be that it's already locked here so that if you're using this with a lot of people, there's less chance of things changing or a linked view getting deleted because you can't really delete it directly from here. So that's another pro, that it's a little bit more set in stone in the way that the structure is defined, as opposed to here, it's pretty easy to move things around, delete things, and between different database pages, the layout could change inside. So it's more uniform to use the database tabs. Next, let's go into some of the cons. For database tabs, some of the cons is the fact that you can only edit it through the customize layout option. So sometimes you might want to quickly change something in here, but actually you have to click here, customize layout, and then go into this layout builder in order to do any of these changes. The other thing is, for example, if I click notes, as opposed to a linked view database, there's no options for different views that are already saved. So it's kind of tedious to actually recreate each of your views using the database tabs. You'd have to go to layout, change it to a different view, and then you might have to go to properties and make sure that the right properties are showing, and then you have to reorder these around and so on. So that could be pretty tedious to create, especially if you already have a pre-existing database setup where you're really happy with all the views. The fact that you have to go in and re-edit everything and build from scratch could be kind of annoying. The other thing is that, as you can see here, when you have this content, the content tab here appears above the property group. This is something that I think that the property group should be above the content notes and event calendar, because I'm so used to seeing my linked view below. And if you want to move this, you can move it to the side panel, but I feel like some people might not notice to open it. So that could kind of hide some of your properties. The other thing you could do is pin properties, but there is a limit on how many you can pin here. So if you don't have that many properties, I think the tabs layout looks really nice. So if I share with you how this looks, you can see the created date here and then the tabs layout here. So I think that looks really good. But if you have lots of properties and you want them displayed in the content, it could just look really odd that you have so many properties below when you actually want to see them when you're on your notes section or your event calendar, but now you can't see anything. So let's say that I have some more properties here. As you can see, there is a limit to how many I can pin. Let's say I put a few of these here, apply all changes. Now to see my other properties, I either have to click view details, or I can also place them below here by clicking move to page. But then if I'm in my notes, I can't see the rest of my properties at all. So I really wish that the properties were above. This is just my personal preference. The other con for me for using the database tabs is that there are no sub tabs. So I typically like to add multiple tabs here whenever I use linked view databases. So if you see here, I do empty view notes. I can reference the need to review view, which I've already created here, and I have two tabs for my notes. However, with database tabs, you actually just have to now add a new tab, for example, notes, and then I would rename this need to review. But then it's hard to know that these both belong to the notes database, but then this one is an event calendar. So in that sense, I feel like it would be nice if there was a sub tab option. So you only see your notes databases here, your event calendar database. So these tabs were by database as opposed to by view. So that's another thing that is a little bit hard to use, especially if you're used to using like 10, 11 views in here, then maybe this is a bit difficult to use because it's just going to get so long in here. So here are my final thoughts with Notion's database tabs. I think that this is a really great step forward with how Notion's databases work. And because everyone was referencing linked views anyway, I think that this is great that you can basically update it once and then everything gets updated across your entire database. So if you have 100 notebooks and you just really want to change the name to be on the left side, you don't have to go through and update every single entry. You can just update it once. So I think that that is a really useful feature of these tabs. Personally, I think I'll be waiting a bit longer in case that Notion adds the ability to reference views that you've already created like these, just because I typically add lots of views to my Notion databases because I like to see my data in different ways, and having to build that from scratch for each separate thing, and also building 10 tabs here doesn't look quite nice. And if you have like 3 reference databases, you could end up with so many tabs all across. I think that if you have a lot of reference databases and lots of relations, then the tabs don't work as well. But for simpler builds, I definitely will consider using these tabs. And I think that this is a really great new feature. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know your thoughts on database tabs. Are you actively using them? If you have any questions or comments, feel free to add them below, and I hope to see you all in the next video.